Vector mediated or indirect gene transfer method is used in plants. The TI plasmid of Agrobacterium tumefaciens has been extensively used for this purpose. TI plasmids are used as gene vectors for transporting beneficial foreign genes into target plant cells and tissues. The foreign gene is duplicated in the tDNA region of TI plasmid in place of undesirable structures. To complement a preferred trait to a crop, a foreign gene which is called as a transgene is encoded. The trait needs to be injected into plant cells together with a cassette of extra genetic material. The cassette includes a DNA sequence termed a promoter, which decides where and when the foreign gene is expressed in the host, and a marker gene that lets breeders to decide which plants comprises the introduced gene by screening or selection. For instance, marker genes may render plants resistant to antibiotics that are not used medically. The examples are agromycin and kanamycin, or tolerant to certain herbicides. The other method of gene transfer is the vectorless or direct gene transfer method. In the direct gene transfer methods, the foreign gene of interest is transported into the host plant cell without the need of a vector. The direct method is a gene gun method, which fires gold elements carrying the foreign DNA into plant cells. A number of these elements go through the plant cell wall and enter the cell nucleus. This is where the transgenic integrate itself into the plant chromosome. Since both methods of gene transfer are equally random, the plant cells must be screened for foreign gene. The methods used for direct gene transfer in plants are the chemical mediated gene transfer. For example, chemicals like polyethylene glycol or PEG and dextran sulfate induce DNA acceptance into plant protoplasts. Calcium phosphate is also used to relocate DNA into cultured cells. Micro injection method. This is where the DNA is directly injected into plant protoplasts or cells. It is particularly injected into the nucleus or cytoplasm using fine tipped. The range of the tip is 0.5 to 1 micrometer diameter, glass needle or micropipette. This technique of gene transfer is used to host DNA into large cells like oocytes, eggs and the cells of early embryo. The next method is electroporation. Electroporation requires a pulse of high voltage applied to protoplasts, cells or tissues to make transient or temporary pores in the plasma membrane. This would facilitate the acceptance of foreign DNA. The cells are located in a solution having DNA and exposed to electrical shocks to create holes in the membranes. The foreign DNA fragments go in through the holes into the cytoplasm and so on to nucleus. The next method is particle gun or particle bombardment method. In this technique, the foreign DNA having the genes to be transferred is covered onto the surface of minute gold or tungsten particles having the size of 1 to 3 micrometers. It is bombarded onto the target tissue or cells using a particle gun, which is also called as gene gun or shotgun or micro projectile gun. The micro projectile bombardment technique was originally termed as biolistics by its inventor Sanford in the year 1988. Two kinds of plant tissues are usually used for particle bombardment. They are primary explants and the proliferating embryonic tissues. The next method is bacterial transformation. This technique is used for familiarizing foreign DNA into bacterial cells. The transformation rate, which is the fraction of cell population that can be transported, is very good in this technique. For example, the acceptance of plasmid DNA by E. coli is accomplished in ice cold calcium chloride in the temperature of 0 to 50 degrees Celsius. It is followed by heat shock treatment at 37 to 45 degrees Celsius for about 90 seconds. The transformation efficiency denotes to the number of transformants per microgram of additional DNA. The calcium chloride breaks the cell wall at particular regions and binds the DNA to the cell surface. Conjugation. As you are aware, it is a normal microbial recombination procedure and is used as a technique for gene transfer. In alignment, two live bacteria brought together and the single stranded DNA is transferred through cytoplasmic bridges from the donor bacteria to the recipient bacteria. Liposome mediated gene transfer or lipofection. Liposomes carry nucleic acids. They are circular lipid molecules with an aqueous interior. Liposomes condense the DNA fragments and then stick to the cell membranes and fuse with them to transfer DNA fragments. Therefore, the DNA enters the cell and then to the nucleus. Lipofection is a very well organized technique used to transfer genes in bacterial, animal and plant cells. Selection of transformed plant cells from untransformed cells is a significant phase in the plant genetic engineering. For this, a marker gene is hosted into the plant together with the transgene tailed by the selection of a suitable selection medium. The separation and steadiness of the transgene integration and expression in the successive generations can be learned by genetic and molecular analysis like northern, southern, western blots and PCR. Transgenic plants produced with beneficial traits. All through the last decades, a remarkable progress has been made in the development of transgenic plants using the various methods of genetic engineering what we studied so far. The plants in which a functional foreign gene has been integrated by any biotechnological approaches that usually are not present in the plant are called transgenic plants. Transgenic crops are cultured universally on many million acres of land by about millions of farmers. Transgenic plants have many constructive behaviors like insect resistance, herbicide tolerance, delayed fruit ripening, enhanced oil quality, weed control and so on and so forth. Stress tolerance transgenic crops. Biotechnology approaches are being established to overcome difficulties initiated because of biotic stresses like viral, bacterial infections, pests and weeds. Also, abiotic stresses like physical factors such as temperature, humidity, salinity and so on. These environmental stresses end result in the damage or deterioration of crop plants which leads to low crop productivity. Quite a lot of approaches have been used and established to build resistance in the plants against these stresses. Abiotic stress tolerance. The plants display their abiotic stress response reactions by the output of stress related osmolytes like sugars. Examples can include trehalose and fructanes, sugar alcohols like mannitol, amino acids like proline, glycine, betaine and particular proteins like antifreeze proteins. Transgenic plants have been developed which overexpress the genes for one or more of the complexes stated. Such plants display improved tolerance to environmental stresses. Resistant to abiotic stresses comprises stress induced by herbicides, salinity, drought, ozone temperature, their heat, chilling, freezing and strong light. Herbicide tolerance. Weeds reduce the crop yield by competing with crop plants for light, water and nutrients. A number of biotechnological approaches for weed control are being used. For example, the overproduction of herbicide target enzyme frequently in the chloroplast in the plant which makes the plant unresponsive to the herbicide. This is done by introducing an altered gene that encodes for an unaffected form of the enzyme targeted by the herbicide in weeds and crop plants. Roundup ready crop plants tolerant to herbicide called Roundup is at present being used commercially in soybean. The biological controls using genetic engineering to grow herbicide resistant plants are overexpression of the target protein by incorporating many copies of the gene or by using a strong promoter, improving the plant detoxification method which helps in decreasing the effect of herbicide, detoxifying the herbicide by using a foreign gene, and alteration of the target protein by mutation. Other abiotic stress tolerant. The abiotic stresses owing to temperature, drought and salinity are together also identified as water deficit stresses. The transgenic plants are made to produce osmolytes or osmoprotectants to defeat the osmolytic stress through genetic engineering approaches. The biosynthetic pathways for the manufacture of several osmoprotectants have been recognized, and genes coding the key enzymes have been secluded. For example, glycine batine is a cellular osmolyte which is formed by the participation of innumerable key enzymes like choline dehydrogenase, choline monooxygenase, and so on and so forth. The choline oxidase gene from Arthrobacter species was used to create transgenic rice with high levels of glycine betaine, providing tolerance encounter to water deficit stress. Researchers likewise established cold tolerant genes numbering around 20 in Arabidopsis when this plant was slowly exposed to gradually lessening temperature. By hosting the coordinating gene, expression of cold tolerant genes was activated, providing safety to the plants against the cold temperatures. The coordinating gene encodes a protein which acts as transcription factor for regulating the expression of cold tolerant genes. Let us now discuss about the insect resistance developed. Different forms of insect caterpillars of Lepidopteran, mites and nematodes considerably decrease the yield and quality of the crop plants. The conventional technique is to use synthetic pesticides which also have serious consequences on human health and environment. The transgenic technology uses an inventive and environmentally friendly method to expand pest control management. Animals have been used to offer insect resistance in crop plants. The first genes existing for genetic engineering of crop plants for pest resistance were Cry genes, which are popularly known as BT genes, from a bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis. These are definite to specific group of insect pests and are not injurious to human and other beneficial insects like silkworms and spiders. Transgenic cotton, rice, maize, potato, tomato, brinjal, cauliflower, cabbage crops with BT genes have been developed. This has demonstrated to be an operative method of controlling the insect pests and has lowered the pesticide use. The most prominent example is BT cotton, which contains Cry1AC gene that is resistant to an insect pest called bollworm, entomologically called Helicoverpa armigera. Isopentinyl transferase gene from Agrobacterium tumefaciens has been hosted into tobacco and tomato. The transgenic plants with this transgene were found to decrease the leaf consumption by tobacco hornworm and reduce the existence of peach potato aphid. Previously, it was witnessed that the wild species of cowpea plants rising in Africa were resistant to an extensive range of insects. It was seen that the insecticidal protein was a trypsin inhibitor that has the ability to destroy insects belonging to the orders Lepidoptera, Orthoptera and so on. Cowpea trypsin inhibitor, abbreviated as CPTI, has no influence on mammalian trypsin and therefore it is non-toxic to mammals. Let us see the virus resistance. There are a number of approaches for manufacturing plants for viral resistance, and this consumes the genes from virus itself. Example, the viral coat protein genes. The virus derived resistance has provided hopeful marks in a number of crop plants such as tobacco, tomato, potato, alfalfa and papaya. The transgenic plant giving coat protein mediated resistance to virus are rice, potato, peanut, sugar beet, alfalfa. The virus that have been used include alfalfa mosaic virus or AIMV, cucumber mosaic virus or CMV, potato virus XPVX, potato virus YPVY. The resistance against fungal and bacterial infections. As a resistance approach against the invading pathogens, which are fungi and bacteria, the plants accumulate low molecular weight proteins, which are together recognized as pathogenesis related proteins or PR proteins. A number of transgenic crop plants with amplified resistance to fungal pathogens are being grown with the genes encoding for the different compounds. One of the examples is the glucanase enzyme that destroys the cell wall of many fungi. The most far and wide used glucanase is beta-1,4 glucanase. The gene encoding for beta-1,4 glucanase has been secluded from barley, hosted and exhibited in transgenic tobacco plants. This gene delivered good defense against soil-borne fungal pathogen Rhizoctonia solani. Lysozyme reduces chitin and peptidoglycan of cell wall, and in this way fungal infection can be reduced. Transgenic potato plants with lysozyme gene giving resistance to Erwinia carotovora have been developed. Delayed fruit ripening. The gas hormone ethylene controls the ripening of fruits. Thus, ripening can be reduced down by hindering or decreasing ethylene production. This can be attained by injecting ethylene forming gene or genes in a manner that will subdue its own expression in the crop plant. Such fruits ripen very gradually, and this aids in exporting the fruits to extended distances without decay owing to longer shelf life period. The most common example or sample is the Flavor Saver transgenic tomatoes, which were commercialized in United States of America in the year 1994. The main approach used was the antisense RNA method or antisense RNA technology. In the regular tomato plant, PG gene for the enzyme polygalacturonase, PG stands for polygalacturonase, encodes an ordinary mRNA that yields the enzyme polygalacturonase, which is involved in the fruit ripening. The complementary DNA of PG encodes for antisense mRNA, which is complementary to regular mRNA. The hybridization between the sense and antisense mRNAs delivers the sense mRNA futile. As a result, polygalacturonase is not created or secreted, bringing about delay in the fruit ripening. In the same way, approaches have been established to block the ethylene biosynthesis, in so doing reducing the fruit ripening. For example, transgenic plants with antisense gene of ACC oxidase, which is an enzyme involved in the biosynthetic process of ethylene, have been developed. In these plants, output of ethylene was decreased by about 97% with a major delay in the fruit ripening. The bacterial gene encoding ACC deaminase, which is an enzyme that acts on ACC and removes amino group, has been transported and expressed in tomato plants, which presented 90% inhibition in the ethylene biosynthesis. male sterility through transgenic approach. The plants may take over male sterility, one or the other form, the nucleus or cytoplasm. It is possible to host male sterility through genetic controls, while the female plants keep up the fertility. In tobacco plants, these are produced by hosting a gene coding for an enzyme called Barnase, which is a RNA hydrolyzing enzyme that inhibits pollen formation. This gene is expressed explicitly in the tapetal cells of anther using tapetal specific promoter TA29 to check its movement only to the cells involved in pollen production. The rebuilding of male fertility is completed by hosting another gene, Bar star, that overpowers the activity of Barnase at the beginning of the propagation season. By using this method, transgenic plants of tobacco, cauliflower, cotton, tomato, corn, lettuce with male sterility have been developed. In this session, we discussed about direct gene transfer and various methods involved in this technique. Latest progress in cell biology and molecular biology has made accessible a variety of methods allowing gene transfer across the borders set by the biology of pollination and fertilization. In the direct gene transfer approaches, the foreign gene of interest is transported into the host plant cell without the need of a vector. To complement a preferred trait to a crop, a foreign gene which is called as a transgene encoding the trait need be injected into plant cells. A promoter decides where and when the foreign gene is expressed in the host. A marker gene lets breeders to decide which plants comprise the introduced gene by screening or selection. Two methods are used to transfer foreign genes into plants. The first method is Agrobacterium tumefaciens. The second delivery method is gene gun, which fires gold elements carrying the foreign DNA into plant cells. The major type of methods used for direct gene transfer in plants are micro injection, electroporation, and particle bombardment.